big are you?
Not too bad. I think there's a gentleman out there to talk to you.
Yeah.
You're John?
Yes, sir.
John, my name is John.
It's on our residence.
Okay.
At Chelsea Court.
Okay.
On 12th Street.
Okay.
I'm visiting. I've been here for about a year.
Okay.
I have a history with Anderson and Milan, the officers.
Anderson doesn't work here.
Okay. Right. So now we're moving on to right now. Hanson, P. Hanson, the new guy.
Okay.
He's with the K-9 training officer.
Okay. I'll have to look up and see. Not my squad, so I'm just...
Okay.
I appreciate telling me names, because I don't know who we're looking into.
P. Hanson is the new guy. He comes up to me, so they just roll up on me. I'm sitting in the car with my pup, waiting for his wife to go home.
Okay.
They roll up on front of me, and go back up. Hanson gets out, says, "Where's your ID?" Yeah. I said, what crime did I commit?
Sure.
He says,
I was just getting ready to ask the same question.
He says, "We were investigating a stalking case down the way, and okay. We have reasonable suspicion."
Okay.
And then stops right there. So I go, "Well, I don't think I need the ID for that. That doesn't, am I being detained?"
Sure.
You know, because we have reasonable suspicion. He doesn't say I'm detained. So I'm like, so the training officer gets out, he walks over, he says, "Are you Ortega?" I says, "Do I look Mexican?" "I'm not Ortega." He says, "Can you prove it? Do you have an ID to prove it?" I says, "Yeah." So I gave him my ID.
And it doesn't say?
It has Loper.
Okay. Yes.
Okay, and I just tried to avoid everything. You know, I'm not going to call the supervisor and do all this stuff. You know, hey, they're protecting the community. I get it. But I don't want to be... Before the cops were trying to manufacture bullshit, Anderson nabbed me with Rosales, I think, and Kaczynski, they got the other dog. And they planted evidence on July 4th.
Okay.
Paraphernalia. Courts dismissed it in the interest of justice because they ran NCIC.
My favorite word.
They ran NCICs on me like an hour before they manufactured the confrontation, and I left, and they pulled me over 3 days. Well, 24 hours later, planted evidence, picked me up. Court case got dismissed. So what I'm trying to do by alerting you right now is that I know I'm under investigation by ICE, okay? I know I am, okay? Because I have a lot of associates that are kind of pissed off at me. Okay,
so okay, I was like...
So if you're running NCIC on me, it's going to look like I'm a fucking murderer, okay? Because they've been doing this shit to me for a while. So I'm just trying to alert you right now that I don't want this stalking thing, this Ortega thing, and then rolling up and dragging my ID off me to be manufactured or something else.
Sure.
Because I have nothing to do with it.
I absolutely understand why you'd be concerned about that. Can I ask you a couple clarifying questions?
Sure.
So you're at Chelsea Court, you're in the car outside of your house. Why would you be, is there a restraining order, no contact order, no protection orders, nothing like that?
Zero.
Okay, so you're waiting in the car. Why weren't you waiting in the house?
Well, we have three chihuahuas, and I have a new shepherd.
Oh, okay.
I'm a puppy.
Yeah.
And
how old?
She's like 9 weeks.
Oh, okay.
I got her off a guy over at Cal Ranch.
Okay.
You know, and the wife really wants it.
Sure.
But her sister has three chihuahuas, and they're really aggressive.
Yeah.
So I'm trying
to... Those lap yappers are... I've been bit by them more than any other dog.
Yeah, he's a real mean little fucker.
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm trying to keep them separate as much as possible.
Oh, okay.
And she enjoys being in the van. It's padded up, and it's dog-proof, you know?
Cool.
Okay. So I'm just sitting there waiting.
Okay.
Mind my own business.
Thank you. Okay, so initially... The things I was looking out for is names, and then, you know, obviously the reason why they would be there. So initially, when you explained that to me, that was a question that I had in my mind, as I was like, well, wait a second, if you're at your own house and there wasn't something going on, why would you be waiting in the car? And then the other question I had, and I tried to pull it up, but I couldn't find it because it didn't have the name yet, but the original information on the call, and I'll give this to you to help you in the future. I really do believe this. So my pet peeve that I hate with cops, and I see it time and time again, is that we can't have a conversation like this, and I explain to you what's going on, but then even more so, we as law enforcement don't explain to you what we can and can't do. So that's kind of like my pet peeve. And so, you know, if I put myself in that situation, and then I'm coming to you and I'd be like, hey, you know, sir, the reason why we're here is because of an investigation. There's a description of a guy. Can I just see your ID really quick to eliminate that you're not the guy I'm looking for, right? You're not the droids I'm looking for.
Yeah.
And right. That seems to go pretty quickly. Where we usually, and I do occasionally have snags with people, is, and usually after I talk to the officer and then I have to talk to you, and I can put you two together and be like, okay, you own the most of it, you own a little bit of it, is usually how, when I talk to people, I'd be like, okay, I think you have absolutely every right in the world to say, can I, you know, am I being detained, what's going on? I absolutely agree with you. And I do have a number of people that do it. The people that I have problems with is the people that say, I disagree with you, I don't believe you have reasonable suspicion. And then I'm like, well, you actually don't have an opinion based on that information. And you don't have a legal right at that point. And the officer has every right to pull your identification, whether you like it or not, when they have reasonable suspicion. And so, I'll be honest with you. If you told me your last name was Ortega, it wouldn't surprise me. If you said your last name was Hernandez, I'd have to look a little bit closer at you. And the reason is because of my background and my history. I can show you a ton. And so I've dealt with a lot of people that are tribal, that are white.
Yeah.
And everybody's like, wait a second, you're an Indian. Well, no, Indian's a dot. Tribal would be Native American.
Yeah.
And so so the whole racial thing really puts me off, because I was raised in a town where white was minority.
Yeah.
And so with the whole racism thing, I always get off on people and I'm like, okay, calm down. But I can show you several instances in town where we have white people with Hispanic names. And so if you had said the same thing to me, I'd come over and be like, I'm sorry, sir, I suck at that game. I'm not very good at it. Could I just see your last name and your ID and I'm out of here? Most everybody is very, very receptive at that point when they see, I really don't care about you. I really don't. I'm looking for XYZ. And most everybody, or if I approach and say, hey, sir, can I get your help really quick? Yes. Hey, I've got a call in this area and I need to eliminate everybody quickly as possible can. Can I see your ID? I'll show you mine. You know, I have no vested interest in you, but it's a thing of there's three people here that could be a bad guy. I need to hurry and get to them. Most everybody, when you explain it to them, they're like, people naturally want to help. They do. Mm-hmm. We are as people. We like to do that.
Mm-hmm.
And so, you know, and I agree with you. Part of the problem that I have is the presentation. Yes, if I'm in a hurry, that's another one. If I have an emergency situation, I got people that want to stonewall me. That really irritates me very quickly. I do raise my voice,
mm-hmm.
and I've yelled at people, and I'm like, I don't have time for your YouTube law bullshit.
Mm-hmm.
I'm telling you right now, I have a legal right to demand your ID. You may not agree with it, and you may believe you're right, but I have the legal authority right now, and you're doing nothing but making my job really hard right now. And then most people are like, oh, he's serious. And then you show the ID, I'm like, thank you for cooperating. Please leave, I gotta do, you know, and most everybody at that point, they're like, oh, he is between a rock and a hard spot, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And when you take that little bit of time to explain that to people, it usually resolves most everything. And then the other thing that I would tell you is, unless you were a bad guy, and I get that, because we do get a number of complaints from people that are like, hey, the officer's harassing me, the officer's this, the officer's that. And then the very first question and I gotta be careful when I ask this, because I'm still a cop, right?
Mm-hmm.
So the first question I ask you is, okay, don't admit anything to me, but in your mind, I want you to answer these questions. If you were the guy that they were looking for, you have not one leg to stand on right now.
Mm-hmm.
And so I try to tell people that, because some people are like, well, no, and, but okay, I'll handle the officer, I'll review his video, we'll go through that. I'm absolutely cool with that. But I try to tell everybody, if you were the bad guy they're looking for, you need to get up and walk out right now, you know, because that's what court is for.
Yeah.
That's what the defense attorney is. And I have some friends that are defense attorneys as well. And so that's why when I talk to them, I'm like, you know, how do you do your job? Why do you do your job? And then they explain it to me, and I'm like, oh, that makes a lot of sense. And so I'll go back and review this and look at, do some more research on it. And then I will kind of, I'm going to have a talk with, find out which officer that Hanson's with. And I'll talk to him and say, hey, presentation. Let's talk about presentation for a minute. If it's not a policy violation, I'm not going further with this. However, if it's a presentation, mm-hmm. I mean, that's what I do.
Angle of approach, maybe?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Yeah. And so I'll talk to them about that and making things more palatable.
I understand.
I like talking about that.
And like I said originally, the only reason I came to you about this is because Hanson straight screwed me. Mm-hmm. He fucking planted evidence. That crew's dirty as fuck,
mm-hmm.
and pardon my English.
They're gone.
Okay, all right. Because the only reason I didn't file deprecation of rights under the color of law is because mm-hmm. I couldn't find a fucking lawyer.
Sure.
Okay.
Yeah, gotcha.
So he's gone, whatever.
Yeah.
And I got some shit bags over in Rigby, mm-hmm. and every time I go through Rigby, they call pig on me because they're feds. Okay, they followed me up in Long Beach.
Okay.
Okay, it's Western states bullshit, and they abuse the sheriffs and everybody.
Well, and everything's a compact state now, too, so whatever happens there comes up here.
And I appreciate, I'm grateful for your time.
Yeah,
thank
absolutely.
You for talking to me, and have a great day.
If you trust me, I'm going to look into this.
Yeah.
And then I will have a if I do see a policy violation, I will give you a call back to file a formal complaint.
I'm going to worry about it.
Okay. You trust me. Okay.
I don't think that's anybody in there, you're gonna ask you so much. I mean, it's over right there, a lie, you know, right between. But I'm just saying, I just want to make it aware that I'm not stalking anybody over there.
I appreciate that. Well, the only thing I've got left, actually, in the few days I've been doing this, the only thing I have left is my work.
That's good to have.
I've seen a lot of things go on in my career, and I need to look at this shit. And, you know, at the end of the day, is, you know, I've seen cops do bad things, I've seen cops do. You know, we all get lumped into, you know, we're all blue, right?
You remind me of the public defender of Enrique.
Yeah.
Yeah, John?
I think I've met him once. He's a good guy.
He's a good guy, too. Thank you, sir.
Appreciate your time, sir. Good luck.
He might have had fucking reasonable suspicion, okay? But the reason I'm here is because I don't know if I was lied to or not. He says Anderson works here still. You said he doesn't. You guys straight fucking planted shit on me because of these feds and ICE. I go, I know I'm under investigation by ICE. He goes, yeah. I go, they followed me from Long Beach. So, telling you the man right now, I don't want this to blossom into a full-fledged fucking forest fire because they fucking manufacture this shit. That might be legit over there, whatever. But the only reason I'm talking to you is because we'll all look into it, and if it was a policy violation, I'll call you back and say, look, I don't need you to even do that. I'm just letting you know what's up. Because okay, well, the only thing I got left is my word. I will look into it, and, you know, and he gave me the John speech.
Really?
Yeah. So I go, look, you remind me of the public defender over in Rigby, so we're good. And take care of yourself, right? I got it on video. So, you know, he tried to, you know, explain it, you know, get him, so I'm talking.